Let's go, girls. Come on. I'm going out tonight. I'm feeling all right. Gonna let it all hang out. Wanna make some noise. Really raise my voice. Yeah, I wanna scream and shout. No inhibitions. Make no conditions, get a little out of line. I ain't gonna act politically correct. I only wanna have a good time. The best thing about being a woman is the prerogative to have a little fun. Oh, 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 they're totally crazy. Look at my lady, man, shirt, short skirts. A chance to get out on the town. We don't need romance, we only wanna dance. We're gonna lay our hang down. The best thing about being a woman is the prerogative to have a little fun. Oh, 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 they're totally crazy. Look at them, a lady, man, shirt, short skirts.
Shake the ground. You held me down, but I got up. Get ready, 'cause I've had. I'm Nancy Brown, Chief Executive Officer of the American Heart Association. It is my pleasure to share this Go Red experience with you. The American Heart Association is a relentless champion of women's health. 17 years ago, Go Red for Women made its debut, and our passion has continued to burn bright every day since. We look ahead with laser focus to raise awareness that cardiovascular disease is the number one health threat to all women everywhere, to engage women from all walks of life to take charge of their health and prevent chronic disease by making healthy lifestyle changes, to close gender gaps in clinical research through Research Goes Red and level the playing field for women in science careers through STEM Goes Red. And foundational is to shake up systems that minimize women's health complaints and limit their access to quality care. Go Red for Women is not just a moniker, it is a movement, and this movement is all about you. You are the face, you are the voice, and you are the vision. Together, we will save our mothers, sisters, daughters, and ourselves. There's no greater force than women united with passion and purpose. Be bold, demand change, fight for a healthy lifestyle, live fierce. Thank you for keeping the movement burning bright.
Good afternoon and welcome to the 2021 New York City Go Red for Women Digital Luncheon. I'm Crystal Cranmore, the race and culture reporter for WABC TV's Eyewitness News, and I'm so honored to be the MC for this special session dedicated to uniting and raising our voices so that all women can live fierce and free of heart disease and stroke. We thank all of you for joining us today and helping the American Heart Association create a world of longer, healthier lives for all. Because when women unite, there's nothing we can't achieve. Now, if you have any questions today, please don't hesitate to enter those questions in the chat box and someone behind the scenes will answer you. And while you're here, go ahead and type in the chat box where you're joining from. Amazing, I see people from all over. New York, New Jersey, Long Island, I see Cleveland, Ohio is here. Welcome to you all and thank you so much for joining us. Now first, before we start, some technical things I'd like to go through. You control your view in Zoom by clicking view options at the top right of your screen. Side-by-side mode allows you to decide how big or small you want each side of your screen to be. Now there's a slide bar in the middle of the screen in side-by-side mode to adjust your view. Now for the best experience, please view today's program in full screen mode. Now today's experience aims to educate, inspire, and empower you to take a world of challenges and turn them into opportunities, not only take action to improve your own health, but the health of those around you. We encourage you to share your experience on social media using the hashtag GoRedNYC. We also ask you to consider supporting Go Red for Women's life-saving mission by making a donation right here today through text to give. Our goal is to raise $75,000 today, and I'm confident that with this incredible group tuning in, we can achieve this. You may donate anytime during the program by texting GoRedNYC with no spaces to 41444. You will receive a reply text with a link to give. Now, please be sure to click the link and follow the prompts to complete your gift. Now, the American Heart Association has also informed me that we have a very generous mother and daughter who want to get the gift giving started. Susan and Catherine Morrissey from White & Warren have agreed to match our first $10,000 raised here today. The American Heart Association's work is life-saving. Just imagine what achievements lie ahead with your continued support, especially when that support is doubled. A special thank you to Susan and Catherine. Now, before I introduce our first speaker, I want to take a moment on behalf of the American Heart Association to recognize our generous sponsors. The success of this movement would not be possible without the support of our national Go Red for Women sponsor, CVS Health, our New York City Goes Red sponsors, the Elizabeth Elting Foundation, Pfizer, Rewire Me by Rose Cayola, and UBS, our presenting sponsor, Northwell Health, our Together to End Stroke sponsor,
Encompass Health, and our life is why we give supporter White and Warren. It's through your support and funding that the American Heart Association is able to work relentlessly every day to save women's lives. Now, we would like to take a moment to thank our Circle of Red and Core Vitae donors who are united by purpose and connected by passion. These generous donors have made a significant gift to further the work of the American Heart Association. This prestigious group is a catalyst for transforming and improving health and well-being. We thank you all for your commitment to helping the American Heart Association create a world of longer, healthier lives. Now, in addition, we want to recognize our STEM Goes Red sponsors. STEM, which is an acronym for science, technology, engineering, and math, is experiencing a troubling gender gap. From the lack of women pursuing STEM-related careers to the number of women in STEM careers and a need for increased diversity. Thanks to STEM Goes Red and our generous sponsors, we have the opportunity to narrow this gap by encouraging high school girls to pursue careers in STEM fields. And now, let's welcome our national Go Red for Women sponsor, CVS Health. Lisa Pasasha, Chief Human Resource Officer and Go Red for Women National Chair, has a quick word to share with us today.
Hello, I'm Lisa Pasasha, Executive Vice President and Chief Human Resources Officer for CVS Health. Go Red for Women was launched by the American Heart Association more than a decade and a half ago to address this troubling reality. Cardiovascular disease is the number one killer of women, claiming 1 in 3 lives each year. At CVS Health, millions of times a day, close to home and across the country, we're helping people on their path to better health. That is why, since 2017, CVS Health has committed more than $20 million to support the Go Red for Women movement, working hand in hand to improve the health and well-being of women coast to coast. I have been honored to serve as National Chair of the American Heart Association's Go Red for Women movement. I'm proud to be a member of the Circle of Red and the American Heart Association's Core Vitae. The reality is, while progress has been made, much work remains in our mission to save more women from their greatest health threat. Women do not experience heart disease and stroke the same way men do. We're still underrepresented in research, and we continue to face gender and racial disparities in both access and quality of care, as well as life-saving medical treatment.
Thank you, Lisa, for that great message. Next, it gives me great pleasure to introduce the 2021 Executive Chair of the New York City Go Red for Women movement, Wendy Holmes. She's the Managing Director and Private Wealth Advisor at UBS. Welcome, Wendy.
Thank you, Crystal, and good afternoon, everyone. I'm Wendy Holmes, and I'm honored to have served as the chair for the 2021 New York City Go Red for Women movement. Today, it's not just about wearing red. It's not just about sharing heart health facts. It's about all women making a commitment to stand together in the fight for heart healthy equity. For 17 years, Go Red for Women has built a network of survivors, advocates, and supporters dedicated to helping women live longer and stronger. Now more than ever, the mission of Go Red for Women needs to shine bright as women have been deeply impacted by the COVID-19 pandemic. Women make up 51% of the US population, and we have a voice that is unmatched. And when we use it together and live fierce, there's nothing we cannot accomplish. The price of being a woman is high. And when it comes to cardiovascular disease, 1 in 3 women pay that price, and 1 is too many. The time is now. The need is critical. Our strength is unmatched. The Go Red for Women movement has the will and the way to help create equitable opportunity by removing some of the barriers that women face to experiencing longer, healthier lives. Because there is no greater, more relentless force in the world than women united with passion and purpose. I deeply thank you all for joining us today and for your support. Who do you go red for? Drop that special person's name in the chat box and tell us who you are honoring today. Part of the reason I go red is because I am inspired daily by the incredible women who have taken a stand against heart disease by joining our New York City Go Red for Women executive leadership team. I want to now take a moment to thank each one of them. Dr. Sanal Bhotia, Rose Kiola, Joanne Dunbar, Kathleen Entwistle, Dr. Jill Kalman, Leanne Kelly, Lori Klein, Dr. Nupur Narula, Beth Oliver, Latricia Parker, Jeanette Piper, Betty Smith, Dr. Suzanne Steinbaum, Jennifer Truscott, Tiffany White King, Susan White Morrissey, and Lauren Young. Let's give these ladies a virtual round of applause. Thank you so much to this amazing and fierce group of women for their dedication and commitment to saving women's lives. This past year has certainly been an unprecedented one. It's full of ups and downs, tragedy and challenges, strength and resilience. But what unites us all is our commitment to join together and raise our voices for ourselves and those we love. We've all leaned on families, friends, and colleagues in ways we never thought imaginable. Through all this adversity, my hope for you is that you have found ways to find peace and happiness. Here's a special message from our Go Red for Women executive leadership team and some of their loved ones on what makes their heart happy. Thank you all again for your support.
What makes my heart happy is knowing that my family is in a good place, that they're happy and enjoying life.
What makes me happy is knowing that I have this guy around for another 33 years, thanks to the work of the American Heart Association, providing the research to help my husband get through an 8-hour surgery and be here today.
What makes my heart happy? Hugging my mama and dad. What else makes my heart happy? Hugging my friends.
And this is my 16-month-old son, Arun. Arun, what makes your heart the happiest? What makes my angel's heart the happiest? Arun, you make my heart the happiest.
Sophia, my love. Tell me what makes your heart happy.
What makes my heart happy is getting to spend time with my family.
And Aubrey, what makes your heart happy?
Seeing my family and my extended family, and most of all, seeing my little puppy.
Oh, what else makes your heart happy?
When it beats.
Oh, when your heart beats. That's right. Why is that important?
Do make bodies alive.
Kaylin, tell me, what makes your heart happy?
Well, I like baking, drawing, and family.
Shay, can you tell me what makes your heart happy?
Rainbows and unicorns and the ice cream truck.
Hey, Sharonda.
Hey, Trish.
What makes your heart happy?
I think knowing that I've contributed to someone's happiness, both professionally and personally, gives me fulfillment and ultimately makes my heart happy.
Awesome.
Nicholas, what makes your heart happy?
My family and soccer.
And Isabella, what makes your heart happy?
My family and my friends.
MJ, what makes our heart happy? I think I need to translate that for everyone. Family makes our heart happy.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Dr. Sanal Bhotia. I'm honored to be one of the members of the executive leadership team, and I'm the vice president and North America medical lead for Rare Disease at Pfizer. I am so proud that my company has stepped up this year to become a New York City Goes Red sponsor. Cardiovascular disease is the number one killer of women, and too many women, particularly our youngest, most diverse women, remain unaware. Losing even one woman to cardiovascular disease is one woman too many. You know, among women ages 20 and older, nearly half have some form of cardiovascular disease. 57% of Black women, 43% of Hispanic women, 43% of white women are all living with this disease. And that is over 56 million women in the United States. These are some truly alarming numbers. It's time to take action to fight back against women's number one health threat. You might at this point be asking yourself, what can I do? How can I prevent heart disease for myself and for my loved ones. First, awareness is key. And not just awareness of heart disease risk, but awareness of the signs and symptoms of a heart attack so that treatment can be sought without delay. As with men, the most common heart attack symptom for women are chest pain and discomfort. However, women are more likely than men to experience some other common symptoms, particularly shortness of breath, nausea or vomiting, and jaw and back pain. And while some heart attacks are sudden and intense, most start slowly with a mild pain or discomfort. I implore you to take charge of your health and seek care immediately if something feels off. The second thing you can do is adopt a healthy lifestyle. 80% of all health disease and stroke-related incidences are preventable through healthy lifestyle changes. This includes making nutritious food choices, being physically active on a regular basis, maintaining a healthy body weight, and knowing your healthy numbers like blood pressure and cholesterol. It also consists of things like getting enough sleep, managing stress, practicing gratitude, and connecting socially, which can contribute to an overall physical and mental well-being. I'm proud to be a volunteer leader for an organization that works tirelessly to ensure that women can protect themselves from heart disease and stroke. And I encourage you all to take control of and advocate for your health today and always.
Thank you so much, Dr. Bhatia, for that empowering and important message. Now let's check in on that thermometer. You know, we love to see that number rising. It looks like we've already reached more than $10,000. That will be matched by Susan and Catherine Morrissey. Incredible. Let's keep that giving going. Remember that you can text GORedNYC to 41444 to make your gift. The American Heart Association is making a profound impact on the state of women's health through funding the research and education needed to prevent heart disease and stroke. Your support is critical to ensure all Americans have an equitable opportunity for a longer and healthier life. Now it gives me great pleasure to introduce a member of the American Heart Association's New York City Board of Directors and Go Red for Women Executive Leadership Team, Rose Caiola. Good afternoon, Rose.
Good afternoon, Crystal. Sorry, I'm a little emotional here watching all those videos and seeing how much money we raised in one moment. Hello, everyone. My name is Rose Caiola. I'm the founder and CEO of Rewire Me, principal member of Bettina Equities Management, and longtime volunteer leader for the American Heart Association. As Crystal mentioned, Go Red for Women is raising awareness and educating women on how to live healthy. But it's also addressing the gender and racial inequities women face in access to quality healthcare and health resources. This includes tackling the social determinants of health, which are factors that influence people's health, where they live, learn, work, and play. When the Go Red for Women team came to me in 2019 and informed me of the severe inequities in the Bronx when it comes to healthy food access, I knew something needed to be done. Food is medicine, and an unhealthy diet is a precursor to developing heart disease. Through the American Heart Association and Grow NYC, I have worked to address food security issues by funding the operation of year-round farmers markets, healthy food box programs, which are crucial during this COVID-19 pandemic, as well as a healthy food prescription program, which allows clinicians to increase fruit and vegetable consumption in hypertensive and other at-risk patients. I'm proud to work with the American Heart Association and continue to support this life-changing and life-saving work. And best of all, I get to do it in my home borough, the Bronx. The simple fact is, the American Heart Association serves as a relentless catalyst for better health and well-being for all. They fund the groundbreaking research that is needed to save people's lives. Heart disease and stroke do not discriminate. They touch every age, gender, and background, and can strike at any unsuspecting moment. Noelia Gutierrez, a young mom, with no known health issues, didn't expect to suffer a stroke 8 days after giving birth to her third child. This is her story.
Noelia vivía antes una vida normal, una vida saludable, sin ningún problema de salud. Su vida era perfecta, todo era perfecto. 8 días después de que Noelia tuvo nuestro tercer hijo, nuestra vida cambió para siempre.
Rescue 70, Memorial West, one adult stroke alert.
Rescue 70, acknowledge stroke alert, go ahead.
Rescue 70 is a relative facility with a 29-year-old female. Chief complaint was right-sided weakness. Patient does have history of anemia and she's postpartum. Stroke assessment on the race scale shows that she has a 6. She does have right-sided eye deviation with right-sided weakness. Relative facility should be there in approximately 4 minutes. How do you copy?
Memorial West, acknowledge.
Copy. Rescue 70 is clear.
When Noelia first came to the hospital, she was almost in a coma. She had generalized weakness in both arms, both legs. In front of our eyes, she was gradually declining. When we took her to the neurointerventional suite, we noticed that there was complete blockage of the artery supplying the brainstem. Immediately, we performed the mechanical thrombectomy treatment that allowed us to open up the blockage within minutes of initiating the procedure.
After my stroke, I couldn't believe it. I thought I was too young. Why only 8 days after I had my baby? There was a lot of questions because I couldn't believe what was happening to me. The hardest part of this journey, I would say, was recovery. I had to relearn everything. Walking, eating, those little insignificant things that you take for granted day by day were the most for me in rehabilitation. Chris was my eyes, my feet. He walked for me, he walked me. That was all I needed to start walking, so I would start getting better. He was 110% of a support. When I got better just in time, I think, for the Mother's Day event. That moment, I felt like, wow. Imagine my daughter being here for this event and not having a mom. That would have been rough. I think they were my biggest motivation to get better, to get up with that boot camp and rehab, to be able to get up and do it all those hours, knowing that I had to get better for my kids.
Noelia is definitely our miracle stroke patient. Had this treatment not been available, even 3 years prior, if she had suffered a stroke, she would have likely been in a comatose condition and nursing home bound. The American Heart and Stroke Association has played an instrumental role in advancing science for acute stroke care. We're all grateful for the treatments that are available today and for the paramedics that brought her to the appropriate center the first time for immediate treatment.
I know that there's a purpose for me somehow in this earth, because I went upstairs and I knocked and they said, no, it's not your turn yet. And I'm thankful for that and I'm grateful, because I would have missed out on a lot in 3 lives.
Wow. Noelia's story is a testament to the fact that heart disease and stroke are not just diseases that only affect older men. They can impact a young, healthy 29-year-old woman like Noelia. Go Red has made considerable progress towards its mission of eliminating heart disease and stroke, but there's still so much more to do. Women are our mothers, our sisters, our daughters, our spouses, and our friends. They give and give and give, often at the expense of their own health. For all of them and for you, I'm asking you to help me draw the line here today. I want you to open your heart to support the work of Go Red and everyone throughout this world. Losing just one woman to heart disease or stroke is one woman too many, and we can help change the statistics here today. Please text Go Red NYC to 41444 to make your gift now. And hold on a second. I'm sorry, 1 minute. I don't mean to be rude here, but my crew is sending me a message. I've just been informed that we have a donor, Eric Wittenberg from UBS, who has generously agreed to match the next $10,000 raised. Oh my goodness. Thank you, Eric. Thank you so much. You're amazing. Thank you for your support. You're just unbelievable. I'm sorry. You know, I personally give to this cause because I know my dollars make an impact. The Go Red for Women movement is accelerating science. They're advancing public health policies. They're closing gender and ethnicity gaps and within research and STEM fields. They're raising awareness in all women and walking hand in hand with women as trusted health partners. Unless we work together to reduce this impact, COVID-19 has the potential to drastically change the health and well-being of people across the globe for many years to come. The American Heart Association has acted swiftly to respond to the ongoing threat of COVID-19 by funding research related to the cardiovascular implications of the virus. They are providing tools and job aids to healthcare providers and ensuring people in greatest need have access to care, proper nourishment, and physical activity during the pandemic. I'm so happy to see all of these amazing donors on the screen. Thank you, Susan and Catherine. Thank you, Emily. Thank you, Alfred. Thank you, Jennifer. We're trying to raise $75,000 here today, everyone. And I know we can get there. I know we can do this. So please continue to give. Thank you, Quincy. Thank you, Carol. Thank you, Danielle. Again, please follow the instructions on the screen and text GoRed NYC to 41444 to make your donation. And don't forget, you must click the link sent to you via text to follow the instructions and submit your card information. I also want to mention the Cor Vitae Society, which is Latin for the heart of life, is an annual philanthropic giving society for the American Heart Association. And it celebrates individual donors, and your gift of $5,000 or more will further the American Heart Association's mission. And with a $2,500 or more donation, you will become a member of Go Red for Women's Giving Society, the Circle of Red. I cannot believe this progress. Look at this, our numbers are just flying up here. Thank you, Beth, Pamela, Scott, Eric, Dawn, Dennis, Sanal, Haiti, Emma. Thank you so much again, all of you, for your generosity and unwavering support. We are so grateful, and I love you all so much. Crystal, back to you.
Wow, thank you, Rose, and thank you to all who have donated. Remember, you can still donate until the end of today's program. Now, we have talked a lot today about the need to support our most vulnerable communities. This year, the American Heart Association launched the Bernard J. Tyson Impact Fund in New York City through the generous support of longtime Go Red for Women leader, New York City board member, and the founder and CEO, of the Elizabeth Elting Foundation, Liz Elting.
Bernard J. Tyson was a visionary who cared passionately about the health and well-being of everyone. His quest for affordable, equitable health care and social justice improved and extended lives throughout the United States and around the world. The American Heart Association is honored to continue his legacy through the Bernard J. Tyson Impact Fund. Bernard considered it a real privilege to make a difference. He inspired us with his wisdom as an AHA National Board member, a member of our CEO Roundtable, and our trusted advisor. This fund will power the American Heart Association's aim to reduce health disparities and address social determinants of health so that all people have the opportunity to live longer, healthier lives, both physically and mentally. In New York City, the Impact Fund is helping to improve access to housing, economic resiliency, and mental health. We are working with the New Destiny Housing Corporation, the Knowledge House, and MindRight Health, all organizations finding solutions that are breaking down the social and economic barriers to health equity.
The benefit of investing in leaders of color that are creating solutions for their community is that they offer an authentic perspective. And through that perspective, they usually offer more holistic solutions that lead to economic empowerment.
Most of our families are people of color and who have been up against the structural racism that is apparent in housing policy and employment and access to healthcare, access to benefits. Small organizations like ours depend on funds like Bernard J. Tyson to help seed new ideas, to help create new programs or to elevate programs.
If I had the chance to meet Bernard Tyson today, I would say thank you for identifying the intersectionality of health and economic mobility. I think very often in underserved communities, it's hard to meet everyone's needs, but it starts with health.
Bernard J. Tyson built his career around health equity, and you know, people can't seek the healthcare that they need when they don't have a place to live.
Thank you, Liz, for sharing that inspiring work and for your steadfast commitment to the American Heart Association. For years, New York City Go Red for Women and Northwell Health have united to be a relentless force for the care of women and advancement of women's health. The American Heart Association's Live Fierce campaign encourages everyone to embrace the power they have within themselves to take charge of our well-being and improve our mental and physical health. Northwell Health's new Raise Health campaign is embracing a similar approach. Our friends at Northwell Health have a special message to tell us how they're uniting with the American Heart Association to raise health so all women can live fierce.
Welcome. I'm honored to serve as the Senior Vice President for the Katz Institute for Women's Health at Northwell and American Heart Association's Eastern States Board President. One in three women die of heart disease and stroke, and one is too many. This year, Northwell Health and the American Heart Association are standing up stronger than ever before. Together, we are raising our voices to reduce healthcare disparities, advocating for gender-based research, and sharing knowledge and resources focused on women's health. I am pleased to be joined today by my colleagues to share how we partner with the AHA to raise health so that all women can live fierce.
Thank you, Stacey. Women comprise half of the world's population, yet only about a third of research trial participants are female. And only 30% of researchers worldwide are women. We're focusing on equity with sex and gender-specific research trials, and mentoring the next generation of female researchers and scientists.
Race, ethnicity, and gender play a unique role in individual risk factors. We are recognizing each patient is unique, and we are beginning to tailor healthcare solutions and healthcare programs dedicated to education, research for their uniqueness.
Frankly, there's not enough women or women of color within the medical field. There are 13% of the US population comprising of African Americans, but less than 3% of cardiologists are African American. Women comprise nearly 51% of the US population, but only 12.6% are practicing adult cardiologists. So as an Afro-Latina, this is particularly close to my heart.
Cardiovascular disease remains the leading cause of death in women in the United States. However, we don't just see this in the form of just coronary disease and heart failure. It also plays a pivotal role in many women who are undergoing both minor and major surgeries. We are taking a multidisciplinary approach and collaborating with primary care physicians, surgeons, and anesthesiologists to provide the best possible care for women.
Heart disease and stroke are the leading cause of all maternal death. Black women are 3 to 4 times more likely to die of pregnancy-related causes than white women. We are working to protect women through all stages of their life.
Stroke from blockage of an artery of the brain or rupture of an artery in the brain is the number 5 killer and the number 1 cause of disability in the U.S. A stroke can be tremendously devastating and very much preventable. We are ensuring that women know the risk of stroke.
We need to empower women to know their unique risk and give them the proper tools to achieve optimal health. Choosing favorable lifestyle changes such as not smoking, maintaining a healthy weight, engaging in regular physical activity, and eating a healthy diet can lower heart disease risk by nearly 50%. Knowledge is power and can help women overcome barriers to medical and self-care that enables them to be proactive in improving their heart health.
We know that women make up over half the population, yet their very unique health experiences are consistently lumped in with men's. This means women's issues are very often misdiagnosed, mistreated, or sometimes just plain missed altogether. Being your own healthcare advocate is imperative. Trust your instincts, speak up, and don't feel guilty or embarrassed about being pushy to get the answers you need. You want to build a partnership with your doctors and the entire healthcare team, because if you don't take care of yourself, you won't be able to run the world.
Research shows heart attacks are on the rise in younger women, and new data suggests younger generations of women are less likely to be aware of their greatest health threat. We are raising the health of future generations to help women live fierce. We are changing the paradigm for the next generation.
Thank you so much, Northwell Health, for your commitment to Go Red for Women and equitable health for all. Now, let's bring up that thermometer again to see where we are. Wow. Thank you, everyone, for donating. I see Penny, Carrie, Suzanne, Valentina, Latricia, thank you again for donating. Now, you still have time to give a gift today by texting GoRedNYC to 41444. Now, we have a spectacular group of leaders we'd like to highlight. This year, Go Red for Women launched the inaugural Women of Impact campaign and united a team of women changemakers. These women are dedicated to making a lasting impact on the health of the New York City community. This group of nominees was chosen to be part of this initiative because of their passion and drive to make a difference. We'd like to thank our inaugural class of Women of Impact nominees. They are Susie David Canyon, Amy Edens, Rina Gupte Joshi, Annabelle Jimenez, Cynthia Lafort, Prachi Makar, Haley Rogers, and Sophia Wagner. Together, this group raised over $28,000 for Go Red for Women. We deeply appreciate all of your hard work and commitment to the cause. Now, as nominees raise funds and awareness, they earned points for their efforts. We are thrilled to announce that our first ever Women of Impact Award winner for New York City, who earned the most points over the 2-month campaign is Rina Gupte Joshi. Congratulations, Rina. Today we celebrate you and all of the nominees for their collective positive impact to further the work of Go Red for Women. Now it is my pleasure to introduce the next portion of our program, a very special fireside chat. American Heart Association CEO Nancy Brown sat down with actress, director, author, and American Heart Association national volunteer Elizabeth Rome for a conversation on resiliency and well-being.
For over 20 years, actress Elizabeth Rome has been a bright light on television and in Hollywood films. TV viewers know her as Assistant District Attorney Serena Sutherland on Law & Order and Detective Kate Lockley on Angel. Her film credits include Joy, Bombshell, and American Hustle. On top of that, Elizabeth recently made her directorial debut with the Lifetime film Girl in the Basement. Elizabeth is the author of Baby Steps, Having the Child I Always Wanted, Just Not As I Expected. Elizabeth is active in a number of charitable causes and is the founder of the Respect Project, a nonprofit promoting respectful dialogue from varied perspectives on essential human topics such as love, grief, and perseverance.
Welcome, Elizabeth. I'm so excited to see you today.
Hi, Nancy. I'm always so happy to be with you.
It is great. And thank you so much for being here and for sharing your personal story. I know that show business can have a lot of ups and downs. What has been your proudest moment?
I guess I always want to sort of couch it in the topic at hand, which is, of course, losing my mother to heart disease. I think so much about my own sustainability, you know, for my own daughter, and you know, really living a heart healthy life and being conscious of that. But along with that is also resilience. You know, I think that life can be challenging, careers can be challenging, and you know, the resilience to sort of pick yourself up, you know, after failure, after difficulty, and readdressing yourself. I mean, that's always the secret to success. It's also the secret to a healthy heart and living a healthy life, because you know, sometimes we all slide and we do something unhealthy, but in the morning after, we always have to remind ourselves that we want to live a long, healthy life for those that we love and that love us.
Yeah, such important perspective. And the ups and downs that you referenced, I think, are so true for everybody. And it's a really strong person who can understand the power of bouncing back. So what's the worst professional mistake you've ever made?
You know, Dick Wolf, who created Law & Order, once said to me, we did a project and it didn't succeed. And I was devastated. And he said, I'm going to teach you something. He said, every time I experience a failure, I always say, next. And I do think that there's the art of living is something like that, meaning what is my biggest mistake when it comes to my career is when I take things personally. You know, when I let them derail me because I've attached myself to the emotion of it too much. You know, I always try to take a step back and have some perspective and not take things personally, because everybody's sort of struggling with their own fight anyway. It usually doesn't have anything to do with you.
What lessons have you learned about falling and getting back up again?
I love this thought, you know, that we have to always lean in to an experience. And I don't think that suffering or difficulty is something to be avoided. I think that's when we should lean in. And I think it should be exciting to us, the idea of waking up each morning, sort of rebirthing and having a new opportunity. So I guess ultimately, I think the difficulty of life, the suffering that's sort of, you know, always going to happen, the chaos that is always going to happen should be, we shouldn't act so surprised by it, right? We should lean into it, embrace it, move through it. The only way out is through. So I don't know why people struggle so much and try to avoid difficulty. Life is difficult, you know? So we have to find the ease in that. And I think within that is a certain kind of wisdom.
You know, speaking of wisdom, you mentioned earlier losing your mom at a very young age to a heart attack. And of course, I know you also lost your aunt. What would you say to them if they were here now?
Well, I would say, you know, this week especially, I had my directorial debut come out on Saturday. And, you know, there was nobody I would have wanted to have seen the movie you know, with more than my mother. And yeah, so I mean, you know, just sharing that with her, and, you know, just, there's just been so many things that have happened since she died 10 years ago, you know, that you would just go through and just share. And you've seen me so many times get choked up so many times talking about my mom and my aunt. Unfortunately, they died so, so young. I'd say I missed you.
It's the phone call you can't make that you wish you could make when great things are happening or when there's problems in your life. You know, everyone wants to talk to their mom. And, you know, it's to me is especially fitting to know for you what a great mom you are to your daughter. And you've been really vocal about having in vitro. You've written about it. You even said that while you were pregnant, Easton's name came to you in a dream. I can just envision that, and it's so powerful. That is a really untraditional journey. What has motherhood taught you about yourself, and what has Easton taught you? What lessons does she teach you every day?
I didn't know the capacity that I had to love until I became a parent, and sort of readdressing yourself to love every morning and how it deepens, you know, through difficulty. And, you know, we can discard other people, but we can't discard our, you know, our children, you know. So when things are challenging, as they can be between ourselves and our children, or so, you know, even with our own parents, every morning is a new opportunity to love more. And so my capacity for love has grown so much more profoundly than I could have ever imagined. And we celebrate my mom. You know, we talked about my mom yesterday, and, you know, she was so compassionate, Easton. So I've learned so much from her. My mom said to me, I was always her greatest teacher, but now I know what she means by that, because she learned how to love unconditionally by having me as her daughter. And that's what I've learned through Easton, is how to love unconditionally.
I love that. What advice do you give Easton? She's entering her teenage years. You probably remember your teenage years. If you could just give her one piece of advice, what would it be?
Well, you know, this is sort of a joke, because I got to direct Judd Nelson in this recent movie, and I had the biggest crush on him in The Breakfast Club.
By the way, we all did. Oh, my gosh.
I mean, seriously, he'd flip his hair back in the, I mean, he was just the most gorgeous. Anyway, I said to him after a week of directing him, I said, I've got to admit something to you. I was so in love with you. In my childhood, I said, had I known I was going to get to direct you in my 40s, I wouldn't have suffered so much. Again, it goes back to kind of what we're talking about, which is, and this actually gets into some of the heart health stuff, like how do we deal with stress? How do we manage stress? How do we balance it? Yes, part of it's what we eat and how we exercise and how we take care of ourselves, but it's a lot of it is also, you know, mental. It's a mental game. Life is a mental game. So I would say to Easton, you know, don't take it so seriously. Don't react so much to things, you know, really try to, don't wrestle with it, you know, so much. We all go through difficult experiences, but don't buy into your suffering. Keep moving forward. There's a beautiful quote that Martin Luther King said, if you can't run, walk. If you can't walk, crawl, you know, just keep moving forward, you know, and I think that a true fighter, somebody who truly loves life and wants to thrive, just keeps moving forward. Don't let things attach to you so much and take it all so seriously.
Such great advice. Really great advice. And I bet it's something that you use and put to work in every area of your life. And speaking of areas of your life, I'm always, when I have the honor to introduce you, it's always breathtaking to me the number of things that you do and the way you spend your time to impact other people. Your charitable work, for example, spans health and welfare, sustainability, and supporting LGBTQ youth. What is the fundamental theme for you that runs through all of these efforts?
Well, I think knowledge is power, Nancy. We talked a lot about that the other day, right? You know, I'm really getting out there with the American Heart Association and creating an awareness of the narrative of heart disease for women, especially. But again, we avoid things that cause us grief or stress or conflict or overwhelm us. But I would, you know, like to suggest that we should become the advocates of our own story, that we need to lean in into the difficult things or the things we perceive as difficult and empower ourselves with knowledge. And I guess ultimately, I think that avoiding things causes suffering and in an unnecessary way. And probably whether it's the American Heart Association or the Red Cross or the Trevor Project or Global Green. It's about, you know, educating, it's about progress, it's about keeping the story moving forward, if it's about getting that narrative out there to as many people, because knowledge is power.
And you have such a great way of telling your story. I know for the American Heart Association, the emotional journey you've been on since losing your mom and your grandmother and your aunt, it's so clear how deeply that's touched you and how committed you are to not let other people suffer the way that you've suffered. So speaking of your mom, if you can think back to the wonderful years when you could pick up the phone and call her and talk to her, what was the best advice she ever gave you in your whole life?
Oh God, she gave me such good advice all the time. She said to me, for God's sakes, I hope you don't lie to other people, but just don't lie to yourself. Don't lie to yourself. And the other thing she always said is tell the truth quickly. You know, we end up getting convoluted so often, and it's just much easier to tell the truth quickly. You know, my mother was an advocate of other people. She was an activist. She was a hippie. And she always said to me, don't treat life as if you're renting. Treat life as if you own, that you have an ownership over this life. Therefore, you have a responsibility to it. We're not just passing through. We have to really make an impact, and not only in our own lives, but on behalf of other people.
And don't leave anything on the table. I've heard you say that before, that your mom had said that to you. So we've loved this backstage glimpse into your personal and professional journey. I'd love for you to give your parting thoughts, your guiding philosophy at work and in life.
I don't know. You know, ultimately, I've always tried to have a childlike enthusiasm for life. And it maybe didn't come that difficult for me to find that. But, you know, if you're struggling, if you're going through difficulty in your life, you know, really don't forget to take a moment to delight in the little things. You know, be really grateful for the little things. I think that childlike enthusiasm, it keeps you young forever. You know, and frankly, it just makes you more happy to appreciate the little things, take the time. And actually going through COVID and this pandemic that we've been through and are still going through, I hope that that is what people carry forward with them, which is that we had the time to appreciate the little things. And there is a mental health aspect to that. There's a physical health aspect to that. Delighting in life with a childlike enthusiasm is a secret to success, I think.
What a great piece of advice. Elizabeth Rome, thank you for sharing your journey with us. Thank you always for being such a good friend. I always feel inspired when I'm with you, because you have a wonderful, calming way to remind us all what's important in life. And we've heard it from you today. So thank you for being with us.
Thanks, Nancy. I love you. Thank you so much.
I love you too. We'll see you soon.
Okay.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Well, thank you so much, Nancy and Elizabeth, for that great conversation. And thank you all for joining us today. We hope that today's program inspired you to improve your health, the health of your loved ones, and the health of our New York City community. Now, don't forget to post your photos on social media using the hashtag GoRedNYC. Now, let's bring up that thermometer one more time. It looks like we're at about 52,000. A little more than 20,000 away from our $75,000 goal. But a huge thank you to everyone who gave today. There's still time to commit to your gift by texting GoRedNYC to 41444. Now, we'd also like to take a quick moment to announce the winners of our registration challenge. Anyone who registered for this event by April 15th had the chance to win a cashmere wrap and beanie generously donated by our Life is Why We Give supporter, White and Warren. Our three winners are Jamil Nelson, Hillary Woodward, and Susie David Canyon. Congratulations, the Go Red for Women team will contact you to make sure that you receive your prize. Now, historically, the Go Red for Women luncheon has been accompanied by a silent auction to raise more funds for the American Heart Association's life-saving work. This auction has not gone away. The Heart Association's team will be hosting a citywide auction later this spring, chaired by Go Red for Women executive leadership team member Kathy Entwistle of Morgan Stanley. Now stay tuned to find out how you can be the winner of luxury items, trips, experiences, and more. Again, thank you deeply for joining us today. Go Red for Women's comprehensive platform has enabled the American Heart Association to increase women's heart health awareness, and improve the lives of women globally. Now, by joining us today, you have become part of this global force and movement. We deeply appreciate your support. Enjoy the rest of your Friday and have a wonderful weekend. Take care and be well.
Let's go, girls.
Gonna let it all hang out. Won't
make some noise, really raise my voice. Yeah, I wanna scream and shout. No inhibitions, make no conditions, get out of line. I ain't gonna act politically correct, I only wanna have a good time.